Is anybody there? Jean. You know, I'm always happy to see you, but to keep coming here twice, three times a day.
I need to confess.
But you already confessed this morning.
I need to confess again.
What terrible sin have you committed since then that can't wait till tomorrow to be forgiven?
I saw a poor monk without shoes, so I gave him some.
There's no sin in charity, Jean.
They weren't my shoes.
Whose were they?
My father's.
I'm sure he'll forgive you.
He already did. But I want Jesus to forgive me too.
Jean, if we were to ask forgiveness all the time, we'd spend our whole life in church.
Is that bad?
Well, no, but... Jean, are you happy at home?
Oh, yes. Very.
And your mother? Everything's fine with her?
Yes, yeah, she's wonderful.
And your sister, Catherine? She's still your best friend?
My sister's just... She's wonderful.
And what about your other friends? You don't like playing with them?
Oh, yes. I play with them. Lots.
Everything sounds... wonderful.
Yes, it is.
Then why are you here so often?
I feel safe here. It's where I can talk to him.
Him?
Well, I tried to talk to him, but mostly he's the one who does the talking.
Who is this he?
Never says his name.
What does he look like?
Beautiful.
And what does he say to you?
He says... He says I must be good and help everyone and take care of myself. Do you think he's coming from the sky?
Perhaps. But wherever he's coming from, I think you should listen to him. Because it sounds like he's giving you very good advice. Io ti absolvo. In nomine Patris, et Filii, et Spiritus Sancti. Amen.
Thank you. Oh, we've all been looking for you. The English are everywhere.
I was in the church.
Really?
I was talking to the priest, and do you know what he said to me?
Run over there!
Tell me that you're...
Quick. I'm here.
Where are you going to be?
I'll be right here. I promise.
No.
Well, that's what I call booty.
Hey, look at this. Frenchmen are such cowards, they've left all the fighting to women.
If that's God's will, then so be it.
Fine with me. I love women. Your turn now.
Bless the soul of this our dear departed. Keep us safe from fear and sin. Amen. Omni Patris et Filii Spiritus Sancti.
Listen, Sean. Your aunt and uncle, they're going to take you to their house for a couple of weeks. Just to give us time to rebuild things here. You understand?
Thanks for the food you've given us. Teach us always to love this land and to save it from those who seek to destroy it. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Good night, then.
What's going to happen to her?
She'll be fine. She'll grow up, find a good man, making some children. Don't worry. She's been hurt, but she'll survive. Tomorrow she'll be as right as rain. You'll see.
I want to see a priest. Did she have to die?
Only God can answer that.
I know Jesus says to love your enemies, but I can't. I just want the anger to burn in hell forever and ever.
I realize your anger, Jean, but we must learn to forgive. It's hard, but revenge will never bring about peace.
What will? And what will bring her back? And why did she have to die in the first place instead of me? Why didn't he pick my life instead of hers? It was my fault. I was late. She gave me her hiding place. Why did he save me?
Calm down, Jean. Calm down. I don't pretend to know God's will. But one thing I am sure, the Lord always has a good reason. Perhaps he chose you because he needs you. For some higher calling. So, as long as you answer that call, your sister will not have died in vain.
I don't want to wait for his call.
Jean, be patient.
I want to be with him always.
Soon you'll be able to take part in the Holy Mass. And when you eat of his flesh and drink of his blood, you will be at one with him.
I want to be at one with him now.
So what did he say?
He says we must bring her to church whenever she wants.
Ah, easy for him. He's not the one that has to do the bringing.
Come on, this is important. We mustn't let her out of our sight.
Don't worry. I will watch her like my own shadow.
With you now.
The Dauphin of France. A message.
message for the Dauphin.
I'll take it.
The Dauphin! The Dauphin!
Shouldn't you be learning your lessons?
I don't want to learn. I want to fight.
You will. You will. But for now, you must at least learn to wipe your nose.
Letter for His Majesty.
Another one from this girl calling herself the Maiden of Lorraine.
I can read for myself, you know?
She pretends she's been sent by God. Charlatans. It's a pity there isn't enough wood to burn them all.
She says she'll be here tomorrow.
You mustn't see her, my lord. We know nothing about her. We don't even know she is from Lorraine.
What difference does it make where she comes from?
If she comes from Burgundy, it makes a difference. It might be a trap. Look, signed X. What sort of a name is X? Or must we assume that a messenger of God can't even write her own name?
My lord Jemai is correct. She says she hears voices. She may be a sorceress, a witch.
Oh, no. You see witches everywhere. She's just a peasant. Peasant who cares about her king. All she wants is to see me crowned and permission to fight for me.
Not exactly. She wants you to give her an army at your expense. Bearing in mind that your mother stole every last piece of gold in the treasury, I fail to see how you can afford such an adventure.
I can see her if I want to. After all, with half of France in the hands of the English, what have I got to lose?
The other half.
You mustn't see her, Your Majesty. She may be an instrument of the devil.
Well, I think you should.
Now, here's an amusing situation. I would love to know why my devoted mother-in-law thinks one thing and my two most loyal and trusted advisors think precisely the opposite.
Because I care about you. Come here. Your health and happiness has always been my first concern, Charles. Ever since you were a little boy. And I think I know you better than your own mother.
You think so, eh?
Yes. I know, for example, the sickness that plagues your heart. I know how painful it is for you to have loved a father without ever knowing if he was really yours. Do I know you enough?
What has that got to do with this maiden?
Who better than a messenger from God to give answers to your questions?
You think she was sent from God?
You're a fine judge of character, Charles. It'll take you less than 5 minutes to expose her if she's a fake. But if she's not, then she will give you your answers and place the crown on your head.
With respect, my lady, I think it's going to take more than just a simple peasant
girl. I'm not interested in what you think from why, or even what I think. It's what simple people think that matters, and the fact is that simple people up and down this country are already talking about her. Now, you know what simple people are like. Always ready to believe any old prophecy. Like this one. About a virgin from Lorraine saving France. And now, this girl comes along from Lorraine. And suddenly there's a spark of hope in their simple minds. We shouldn't disappoint them, Charles. If they believe in her, if she can put back the fire in our army, then I believe in her too.
Thank you.
be quiet for once.
She's coming, Your Majesty. All right, all right. Calm yourself.
Your Majesty, I urge you not to see this woman. It all reeks of Burgundian trap.
My astrologers assure me that the timing is propitious. Leo with Virgo rising. Have you never noticed on the astrological chart that the Virgin is next to the Lion?
Supposing she's an assassin?
My dear Tremoy, I'm not even king yet. Who would want to assassinate me?
She's arrived, my lord. She's in the guards room.
Fine. I suppose I shall have to make a decision. Why is life so complicated? Sometimes I really wish I could be someone else.
It's a good idea, sir.
What do you mean?
Let someone else pretend to be you.
And see if she can find me. That's a brilliant idea. If she's really been sent by God, she'll discover the trap. And if she's an assassin, she'll kill the wrong man. Brilliant.
Please! We're going to play a little game. Now, let us pretend that my throne is empty. Just pretend. Who wants to be king? Now there's a heartwarming sight. Now, let us see which one of you could possibly pass as the king of France. Alençon, my noble duke, my royal cousin. So fine, so brave, so rich, so very rich, so far too rich to be the king of France. Everyone knows I'm the poorest man in my kingdom. Gilles de Rais, Marshal of France. Formidable to men, fascinating to women, feared by all. You would be perfect to sit on my throne. So perfect that you might like it too much and therefore disturb my fragile peace of mind. Lair, my angry captain, bravest in France. Scarred by a dozen wars, but with a heart and stomach for a dozen more, you could pass for the king.
Damn bloody right I could.
Until you open your mouth, because no one with a tongue like that could possibly pass as king of France. Well, it looks like it shall have to be me after all. Why not you? Jean Delon. The only man who's poorer than I am, therefore the only man I can trust. Dignified, honorable, wise, what more can we ask of a king?
My lord, I'm not sure that...
Are you not prepared to die for your king?
Of course I am.
Good. Until then, feel free to live like a king. Bring her up.
Sire, you know how bad I am at this sort of game.
Pretend it's not a game.
Make way for the Dauphin.
Mother?
Not now.
I've come to see the Dauphin. Who are you?
I'm
His Most Gracious Majesty Charles de Valois, Dauphin of France.
Yes.
I can see you're a good man. But you're not the Dauphin. I'm sorry to insist, but I must see the Dauphin. We have no time to lose. Where is he?
He's here. Find him yourself.
Now you'll see what pass for a king. How did you know who I am?
Her voices, of course.
That's him, they said. The one in the corner with the big nose.
No! Back off! Over!
Oh, my gentle Dauphin. Oh, my gentle Dauphin.
Dear loyal Tremor,
I know I can count on
as
you.
As always, Majesty.
To ensure our privacy, I need to talk to her alone.
He needs to talk to her alone.
Fine. Beautiful spring day. I was taking a shortcut home through the forest when a strange wind began to blow. It was such a strange sound, almost like words calling me. Many years later, I was coming back from church, and suddenly, the same violent wind. Then, a shape appeared in the middle of the sky. The shape of a man. Everything was moving so fast, so fast. The wind, the clouds. I couldn't move. I couldn't breathe. God had chosen me, but I did not understand what it was he wanted me to do. What was my mission? What could I do to help my country? But how? I was nothing. I was just a poor girl. Oh, I did not know anything about making war or writing. So I decided to wait. And not to speak of it to anybody.
You did well. You did well.
I didn't wait long. Mass, like I do every day, when the same strange wind
blew.
was made clear. God had given me a message. A message to deliver.
What was the message?
France from her enemies and bring her back into the hands of God. And he told me that I, Jeanne, will lead you to the altar at Reims, where you will be crowned the king.
I'm fine.
Jeanne, this is in fact Jeanne Delon, my loyal friend and finest archer. Jeanne, I put her in your care. Find her suitable lodgings here in the castle and guard her with your life.
Sire, I won't be needing any lodgings if we're to be marching on Orléans.
Well, Orléans has held out for 6 months, so I don't suppose a few days more will make much difference. Take some rest.
Please accept my apologies for me pretending to be the, you know.
Do you think that I could have some water?
Water? Yes, of course. Would you get some water? Anything else?
I need to see a priest.
Now?
Yes. I didn't confess today.
Right. Raymond, a priest. Anything else?
I shall also be needing a new war horse, a sword, armor, and an artist to make a banner for me.
Now?
Better today than tomorrow.
This might take a little time, but let me see what I can do.
Oh, I shall also be needing someone who can read and write.
This I can do. I was studying at the University of Paris until the English invaded it.
I thought you were an archer.
Yes, I am. I'm an archer who can read and write. Who do you want to write to?
The King of England. I want to give him the chance to leave in peace. Before I get to Orléans.
Archbishop and I have just begun delicate negotiations with the Burgundians. If we can bring them over to our side...
Negotiate by all means, but from a position of strength. If the English take Orléans, there'll be nothing left to negotiate. The rest of the country will be theirs.
My lady, it would be the height of folly to let this child lead our army in the king's name without verifying her true motives.
My Lord Tremeyer is right. We must be absolutely certain that she is not an instrument of the devil.
How can anyone be absolutely certain about anything? Sometimes our intuitions are our best counselors.
We must listen to Mother Holy Church before we listen to our intuitions.
Wait. She claims to be a virgin. Well, that's something we can examine and be absolutely certain about.
Let's find out. Thank you.
Edo in unum Deo, patem omnipotentem, factorem cela et terra, visibilum omnium invisibilum, et unam sanctam catholicam.
What if she's not?
If she's not, I'll kill her myself.
Confiteorum num baptisma in remissionem peccatorum.
There is no sign of corruption or violation. She is intact.
And what exactly was this vision wearing?
I don't remember.
This vision, did it give you anything? An object, a ring or a rosary, anything by which we can verify your claim?
He gave me good advice.
During your childhood, do you have any sort of military experience?
No.
Are you practiced in the skills of swordsmanship?
No. But I'm good with a stick.
Do you know what a Dijon culverin is?
No.
It's an item of artillery. How can you expect to raise the siege of Orléans if you're ignorant about modern artillery?
The road to Orléans is long, and I have good captains with me. I will learn fast, believe me.
We would like to believe you, Jean. But we feel that if God wanted us to believe you, he would have sent a sign with you. So, can you do something? Show us something? A sign to prove that you are sent by God.
I did not come here to perform tricks. You are all much cleverer than I am. I don't know A from B, but this much I do know. That while the people of France lie bleeding, you sit around in your fine clothes trying to deceive me. When you're only deceiving yourselves. You say you are men of God, yet you do not see his hand in having guided me through 500 leagues of enemy country to bring you his help. Is that not proof enough? Do you still need more signs? Give me an army. Take me to Orléans. And there you will see the sign that I was sent to make.
What?
A big one. Straight at us.
What side?
Window side.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Dunois!
What?
I have wonderful news. Finally, he's sending her to us. Thanks be to God, we're saved. It's wonderful.
Calm yourself, Xantrai. Who has finally done what?
The Dauphin. He's sending us food and supplies and an army, led by Jeanne, the maiden from Lorraine. Isn't it wonderful?
Yes, it's a miracle.
I can't believe they are sending a woman.
I wonder what color dress she'll be wearing.
Blue. With the blue ribbon in her hair to tie up Talbot. Does anyone know if she even knows how to ride a horse?
She knows.
Yes, they were.
Where are the English?
Everywhere. Where's the food?
It's coming. I rode on ahead. I have a message for the captain of the English army. His name is Talbot.
I know.
Can you take me to him?
He's on the other side of the river.
So, who gave the order for me to be brought to this side of the river?
Hey, my friend! Good to see your ugly damn face again.
Lair, I'm warning you. Don't swear.
Sorry, Jean. Let me introduce the king's half-brother, the dogged Lord Dunois.
And Lord Dunois, will you show me to the other side of the river?
Wait! Wait! Wait!
Fine! Go now if you want! But not with me! You may have a duty to God, but I have a duty to my people. And my people are starving. Right now, I'm going to take the food back to the city. And if you can please calm down and let me accompany you to Orléans, it will be my honor to welcome you.
Happy to welcome you in my tavern. Come on in. Lair, Gilles, let me show you something. Tourists are around here. The river crosses there. Current is this way.
John, I would have thought. Calm down. You can't blame those people. They've been hearing about you for weeks.
There's nothing to hear. Why is there nothing to hear? Because I haven't done anything. And why haven't I done anything? Because none of you will listen to me!
Why don't you join us? We're about to discuss the campaign. So from here, Talbot has spread his forces within this part up here. But in the last few days, it seems, according to our scouts, that some troops have been deployed to this fort here.
And what about this huge pile down here?
That's the Tourelle. The English were planning to launch an attack from it, but then we broke down the bridge.
I did. Yeah.
Which should keep them quiet for a while. Now, my hunch is the attack will come from Saint-Lô here.
And what does Jean think?
I don't think. I leave that to God. I'm nothing in all this. I'm just the messenger.
So? What is the message?
We give the English a last chance to go home in peace.
And if they refuse?
If they refuse, we recross the river and attack here at the Tourelle.
Jean, that really makes no sense at all. The Tourelle is virtually impregnable. Besides, if we are on the other side of the river attacking the Tourelle, what's to stop Talbot attacking the city from the north?
God.
God? Why, of course. We'd forgotten about him.
I feel a great sorrow for you. Because you're laughing now, but by tomorrow night, some of you will be dead.
Jean, with respect, we can't just attack the Tourelle like that. It's a very complicated matter.
So complicated about it. All you have to do is do what you're told. What could be simpler than that? I am the drum on which God is beating out his message. He's beating it so hard, it's bursting my ears!
Jeanne, you have to understand, it's not easy for us. I mean, for our bride, to suddenly be usurped by... Well, with all due respect, by a girl.
Oh. So that's it. To you, I'm just a girl.
Put yourself in my shoes for a moment. How would you feel if you were me?
Knowing what I know? Enormous gratitude.
One hell of a girl, huh?
I warned you.
You do love her. When her fire gets well, I'm truly stoked.
Me too.
Hello, my friends. What a journey. Have we made it? Back together again. Let's have some fun.
Fine. You look like a man.
Jean! Stop it!
How dare you stop me from doing God's will?
He didn't tell you to cut all your hair off!
How dare you tell me what God tells me to do?
Whatever, but since he's not going to come down and cut it himself, I mean, at least let someone cut it properly. Raymond, bring the scissors. Louis, fetch the mirror.
Jean, stop getting so angry about everything. Calm down.
I am calm. It's God that's angry. I need to send a letter now.
Fine.
To you, Henry, King of England, and to you, Duke of Bedford, who call yourself Regent of France, obey the King of Heaven and abandon your siege. Give back the keys to the other towns you have taken and go back home to your island. To you, Lord Talbot, I beg you, as humbly as I can beg you, for the sake of the lives of your soldiers, do not bring about your own destruction. Surrender to me, Jeanne the Maiden, who is sent here by God.
Message!
But if you do not heed my warning, then we shall raise such a battle cry as there has not been heard in France for 1,000 years.
Sire, message.
This is the third and last time I will write to you. If you are still here at noon, I warn you, you will hear from me to your very great destruction. Please give me your answer speedily.
Go fuck yourself!
What did they say?
They said they'll think about it.
Good.
But, to be honest, I don't think they'll leave tomorrow.
I can't wait for tomorrow.
The gate!
idea.
Where the men confess. Where are the priests?
We didn't take them. We wanted to be fast. Wanted to make a surprise attack.
Dunua, was it you who gave the order to attack? Answer me!
Can we discuss this later?
Sooner is better than later.
Hey!
Hi!
Wait!
Hey!
Wait to be killed! Is closed.
Not for long.
Great victory, Jean. Your victory. But we must follow it through and pursue the English back to Talbot's camp. Unless, of course, you have another good idea.
First, we find the biggest army we can. Then we return to Orléans.
The bridge has been pulled down.
The English are rebuilding it.
And how do you know?
You have been with your council, and I have been with mine.
Come on, hurry up!
Be careful with my baby.
That's the Tyrell.
Wonderful.
Captain! Looks like the Froggy Whore's coming to pay us a visit.
I better tell Glasdale.
put the horses over there.
Fathers, fathers, please, bless them. Please, bless them all.
We will.
Let's plan this attack a little more carefully than this morning.
Yes, good idea.
Sire. We've got, visitors.
Man the walls.
This morning, God gave us a great victory. But it is nothing compared to what he is ready to give us now. I know you are all tired and hungry, but I swear to you that even if these English were hanging from the clouds by their fingertips, we would pull them down before nightfall. Now, let all those who love me follow me!
Thank you.
You just killed my woman! Captain! Captain! Captain!
Go to hell.
Call the physician! The physician! Damn it!
Do we find the physician?
We have to dig out the Yara now. It's in so deep, I'm afraid she'll bleed to death if we pull it out now.
There must be something we can do for her, for Christ's sakes.
Yes. You can pray.
Good idea. I swear that I will never swear again in my life if you save her life. But I'm warning you, if you let her die, then you're the biggest...
Right here.
Swear.
He heard me.
Why aren't you fighting?
Yeah, you've been badly wounded.
It's not... It's
a narrow. And it's in deep. Sean, you must stay still till the physician arrives.
Physicians are a waste of time. You'll have more luck with this charm of mine. Save my life, Agincourt.
I'd rather die than use magic.
Sean, you will die if that arrow stays in you much longer. No.
Anymore. Now, let's go to the battle!
Sean!
Sean! No!
Please!
No!
She's nuts. You must stay calm. You must rest.
I'll rest. But you have to promise me.
I promise.
Jen!
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 Jen! Jen!
Guys! Hurry!
Quickly, do something!
She's sleeping.
What?
That's one, hey! Come on! Come on, Bob! Why are you running away?
Jan is alive.
Good.
We have to press on the attack.
Sound a retreat.
But I promise Jan we fight on.
I made no such promise. Sound a retreat for the night.
No, but that was her order.
I'm fed up with taking her orders! She swore she'd defeat the English before nightfall. Instead of which she goes and plays the fool, gets herself nearly killed. Look! Look at the mess we are in! That's her mess, not mine! We're worse off than if she'd never come at all. Now do as I say, and sound a retreat.
Where are you going? Hey, come back!
What are you making?
A message for the English. So, what are the men saying?
She's a gift from God. Some even calling her a saint. I'd gladly follow her through hell if I had to.
Will you go that far? She asked you to?
Of course I will. I've been there before. One thing I don't quite understand. She's been sent to us by God. Why does he allow her to be wounded so badly?
So maybe the good question is she really sent by God?
Who knows?
God knows.
What happened to your precious angel? Huh? Frenchies! Frenchies!
I'll tell you what happened!
We sent the little bitch back to hell!
So she can go back with the devil! What are you gonna do now,
Frenchies? Why not come out and fight? Come on! Or are you too busy praying to bring your little fucking witch back from the dead?
Do you hear me?
I hear you! I'm alive! May God forgive your blasphemy. I never will. I never will!
John, what are you doing? You need to rest.
We must wake up the soldiers. Now!
But John...
If I find soldiers, wake up! If I find soldiers, wake up! Two arms! Two arms! Wake up! We must fight the battle! Wake up! Wake up! My fine soldiers! The battle has begun! Wake up! Two arms! Wake up! The time has come! Come on! Up! The battle has begun!
They're here.
Two arms!
Taking back the trail.
Come on!
You ready?
Hey! Go wake up, Glasdale.
are you doing?
I'm sending a message to Glasdale.
With that?
Yes?
But you've got it back to from.
Listen, I know what I'm doing. So, either lend a hand or get back to bed.
I'm going to send a message to Glasdale too.
My lord?
What?
The French witch. She's back from the dead.
Hurry up, men!
Jean, don't you think we should take some time to think about this?
This one.
The fuck is your plan now?
I don't know! The question is, what is she doing now? How can we plan anything if she doesn't at least consult with us?
Did you consult with her yesterday?
Don't even start, Alonso. You agreed to attack yesterday too.
Yes, but that doesn't count.
Why is that?
Because I always agree to attack.
Bitch. She doesn't even know how to use it.
Come on! Come on, go! Go!
Go! Oh my god.
Thank you.
and we load this up as a battering ram.
Already done.
Nothing.
Please.
Yes. As you command.
What are you doing?
We're going to open that door. Isn't that what you want?
Get out of my fucking way! Philip Coleman! Fucking French! Don't fucking know about me!
Reload!
Reload!
What are you doing, John?
I'm playing.
What are you doing to me, John? What are you doing to me, John?
What are you doing to me, John?
John!
Do you hear me?
Are you all right? Do you hear me?
Yes.
Calm down.
Yes.
It's over. We won.
We won?
Yes.
Jean, my friend, my soldier,
in my arms.
We won.
Won? No, Jean. So small a word will never do. This is victory. This is glory. Yeah. Jan? 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 What's the matter?
Jan.
This is Glory.
You look disappointed. Isn't this what you wanted?
No. Not like this.
4 weeks you've been asking for this. Well, now you have it.
What are you doing?
Nothing. I'm just taking his teeth.
But you can't just kill a man for his teeth.
Well, why not? He has good teeth.
Because he can't.
What about all this?
But that's different. I mean, we were fighting for a cause.
Not me. He is my prisoner. I can take his teeth if I want to.
No! You can't stop it! No, here. Take this. He's mine now. Here, you! Go. Go!
Bravo! And what about all the other prisoners? Do we let them go too?
I don't know! Maybe. We must confess. We must confess. Please, we have to be confessed. All of us. Now, I know this is not normal custom, but, everything's gonna be fine. He's gonna confess us. Neil.
Some brings bad news. The English are forming up, thousands of them, on the far side of the river. I think we should count our men and get ready.
Let's go!
I'll go. Alone. For your King Henry. It is a message from God. Go home. Go now in peace. If you do not go now, you will be buried in this field. I've seen enough.
blood. But if you want more, I can't stop you. I can only warn you that it will be your blood, not ours. I'm waiting for your answer.
Hold the horse!
Never wait for miracles. Stand by to attack.
Whoa!
She was on her white horse alone, facing the whole English army, and she drove them away. And now, Orléans is free.
We lost Orléans.
I want that girl. I want that girl.
I see the seamstress. It's too tight. I can't breathe. That's meant to be a crown? Don't you have something a little more regal?
The English took the real one.
It's been muddy for so long, I forgot how good it looked when cleaned up.
But did you remember to clean up what's inside as well?
I asked for a grandiose coronation, and this is what you get. This whole thing is going to be an utter fiasco.
It'll take me 3 days to prepare. Your father's coronation took 3 months.
He's probably right. We should call for a delay.
There's no time, sir. We can't hold up the ceremony. There's no telling when the English might come back.
They're... Let them come. Let them see who is the true king of France.
Well.
Those damn English, we should be doing this in Paris, in Notre Dame. It is much more prestigious and twice as big.
It's the sacred place that matters, Charles, not the size. Am I correct, Bishop?
Oh, yes, my lady. All true kings of France must first be anointed in our great cathedral of Reims with the holy oil of Clovis.
Your Grace, there can be no anointing.
What in heaven's name are you talking about?
The holy oil of Clovis. It's all gone.
Gone with that symbol. It's a magic oil, miraculous oil. It could never be exhausted.
Look for yourself.
Problem?
I just don't understand. Oil of Clovis. It was quite full the last time I saw it.
And when was that?
At the coronation of King Charles VI.
30 years ago. Does it surprise you it's gone?
But you don't understand it. It's no ordinary oil. It's a miraculous oil. It was brought by a white dove from heaven to crown King Clovis in this very cathedral. What should it be?
Performing a miracle.
the sacred oil. Blessed by the hand of God the Father Almighty, we do anoint thee, Charles Valois, to be sovereign lord and king of this great kingdom of France, charging that ye shall defend the faith of our Mother Holy Church as long as ye shall live. Amen.
You have an arrow in your leg.
So there is. But that doesn't stop you from climbing. Well, climb! Go! Go! Raven! Take this arrow out of my leg.
Jean, the men are exhausted.
I know, but so is the enemy. They're falling back. Paris is ours.
Jean, we are not enough.
So, bring up the reinforcements.
Reinforcements? Where?
Right behind us. Dunois with another 10,000 men.
Jean, look behind you.
Never look behind, only ahead.
Do you know how to count?
Of course I do. So, bring them up!
Jean, that is not 10,000 reinforcements! That is 100 very loyal but very tired soldiers!
But, where's Dunois? And where are the men that can promise me?
He never sent them! Don't you understand? He doesn't want this war anymore. He has his crown now. That's all he ever wanted.
But my voices, they promised me.
To hell with your voices! It's time to face facts! We have nothing to do here! None of us! Not even you!
You don't believe in me anymore?
Jean, of course we still believe in you. If it were up to me, I'd chase every last goddamn Englishman into the ocean. But it's not up to us anymore. It's up to the king.
You should go home, Jean.
To pay for the size of army she's demanding. The girl is crazy.
Her victory at Orléans was a miracle. Everyone knows that, but we can't wait for a miracle when we build a future for France. Paris was a disaster.
Mm-hmm. God wasn't with her then.
God deserts her. What do you think we should do?
No, no.
Why did you betray me?
Paris was ours for the taking. All I needed was another few hundred men. Why did you take the army you gave me?
Gave you? I wouldn't quite put it that way.
So how would you put it?
Well, we are, of course, enormously grateful for your past efforts. But now your task is done. Now is the time for negotiation.
Peace will only be got with the English by the end of a lance.
Why are you so bloodthirsty? Do you enjoy it?
No.
Diplomacy is far more civilized, far safer, and far cheaper.
I have letters here from towns under siege, where your people are starving, begging God on their knees to help them. And I'm here to answer their prayers. And you want to stop me? France does not belong to you, Charles. She belongs to God.
Only she would just go home.
What am I supposed to do now?
What do your voices say?
They haven't spoken to me in weeks. Not since the coronation. No signs, nothing.
Maybe their silence is a sign. Maybe it's a sign to go home.
No, it's not time yet. My mission isn't over yet. There's still so much I have to do.
But how do you know that these voices aren't just really you?
Well, they are me. That's how God speaks to me. Even you could hear them if you listened hard enough.
You make it sound so simple.
So even you don't believe in me anymore?
Sean, I believe in you more than anyone. I just wish I could help you.
There is one thing you can do if you want to help me.
Tell me.
Tell the king to give back the army that he gave me.
We have to stop her, Your Majesty. If she raises her own army and attacks the Burgundians at Compiègne, all my months of painful negotiations will have been in vain.
Jeanne has done so much for us.
I can assure you, Charles, the maid has no greater admirer than myself. But whatever our personal feelings, we cannot allow her to conduct her own private war. For the sake of the kingdom, it is imperative that you stop her going to Compiègne.
I can't stop her.
Well, if you don't, I'm sure the Burgundians would be happy to oblige. If they capture her at Compiègne.
No one can blame us.
But it could sound like we betrayed her.
No, no, never.
Heavens, no, no.
Don't worry, Shahar. If God is still with her, she will be victorious.
But her army is so much smaller.
Then her faith will have to be bigger.
Open this gate immediately.
I can't reach the safety of my tunnel.
What? Take my ladder! Dad!
Thank you.
I can't believe it. The romantic vision of death with all that grass growing everywhere. I must admit you have a big imagination, but maybe not big enough. Death is much more simple. After a few months, it gets more interesting. Then after a year, it finally becomes romantic.
Who are you?
You don't like my face. Maybe you prefer this one. Too young, maybe. How about this one? Better, no. But incomplete.
Get them behind me, Satan.
Who are you to even think you can know the difference between good and evil? Are you God? How can you possibly imagine that God, the creator of heaven and earth, the source of all life, could possibly need you?
I don't know.
You don't think he's big enough to deliver his own messages?
What do you want from me?
Nothing. I'm here to set you free.
I said smile. You have visitors.
The Duke of Burgundy.
So here's the famous Jean, savior of Orléans, terror of the English.
My king will pay any ransom you ask.
Your king?
Oh, yeah, of course.
What's he gonna pay me with? Cows? Chickens? I prefer gold. And the English have plenty. I wonder how much they'll pay to have the Witch of Orléans in their clutches. Those English are so arrogant, they can't accept the idea of being defeated by a peasant girl. It has to have been the devil's work.
God defeated the English.
And God, who allowed you to be caught? Personally, I don't believe in God. I don't believe in the devil either. That's why I'm never disappointed. Sell her.
Jean's ransom. All the captains gave what they could, as well as citizens of Orléans.
Oh, that's very generous of you. How much?
10,000 gold crowns.
10,000? That's a lot.
Your Grace, I place you in charge of this very delicate negotiation.
Yourself ready, your lady.
Who are you?
Pierre Cauchon, Bishop of Beauvais. As you were captured in my diocese, the duty of conducting the trial falls upon me.
Trial? What trial?
Your trial, Jeanne. On a charge of heresy.
Didn't he pay my rent?
It seems the English care more about you than the French.
The English?
Yes, they paid your ransom. Tomorrow you'll be transferred to their great castle at Rome.
Our most serene and Christian king, Henry VI, King of England and France, has placed this girl in our hands, accused of a number of heretical deeds, to be tried in a matter of faith. Take the Holy Gospels in your hand and swear to tell the whole truth regarding anything you may be asked.
I don't know what you're going to ask me. You may ask me things that I won't want to answer.
You will swear to tell the truth about everything you are asked.
I will willingly swear to tell the truth about all earthly things. But as to my revelations, I've told no one except my king. Charles VII, the one and only king of France.
You must take the oath. Not even a king would refuse to take an oath to tell the truth in a matter of faith.
I will tell you all that I'm allowed to tell you. But as for the rest, even if you threaten to cut off my head, I won't tell you.
Begin by telling us your name, assuming you're allowed to tell us that much.
My name is Jeanne. My little cross that I had around my neck was taken from me. May I have it back?
Show us a little more cooperation first. Where were you born?
In a village called Doremi.
How old are you?
19, or thereabouts.
Were you baptized?
Yes.
Recite our Lord's Prayer.
Not unless you hear my confession.
Jeanne, listen to me very carefully. We are all men of faith, and we shall earnestly strive for the salvation of your body and your soul. We do this in the name of our Holy Mother Church, who never closes her arms to those who would return to her. But we cannot help you unless you submit to our learned judgment and authority. Take heed of this charitable admonition, for if you persist in refusing our help, we shall have no choice but to abandon you to the secular powers. And I think you know well enough the punishment that would await you. So, now, will you please recite our Lord's Prayer?
Not unless you hear my confession.
Jeanne, be careful. You are not helping yourself by refusing to submit to our judgment.
You, who claim to be my judges, you be careful! For you too one day will be judged.
Guard, take the prisoner away!
Well, I think in future we should conduct our inquiries in private, away from public pressure.
Let the English burn her if they want to. Why does it have to involve us?
Because it's our clear duty to root out heresy wherever we find it. Father Vincente, you're the most venerable among us. What do you think?
I think this trial is a masquerade, and I won't be part of it anymore. I'm willing to be her judge, but not her executioner.
That's what I'm trying to ensure.
The verdict comes at the end of a trial, Cauchon, not at the beginning. I am going back to Rome to give my report to our Holy Father, the Pope.
Well, this is ridiculous. Now I'm the one who's on trial and being judged.
Arrest him.
What are you doing?
Hey, what you doing?
This is an ecclesiastical court. You've no right to do this.
This is English territory. I have the right to do anything. Is that clear?
Someone else?
Yes.
Who?
My visions.
Your visions? They're going to come and visit you in here.
Yes. That's what I pray for.
I want to see that. Do you mind if I stay on the side here? I won't bother you.
No! No! No, you can't. You can't. Or else they won't come.
Why won't they?
Because I have to be alone.
Oh. They won't come anyway.
What do you mean they won't come?
Why would they?
Because I've always been faithful to God, and I've followed everything he's ever said, and I've done everything he's ever asked me to do.
God asked you to do something?
Yes. Yes, lots of things.
You mean God said, I need you, Jean?
No. But he sent me signs.
Signs? What signs?
The wind.
Wind?
And the clouds. Ringing.
Ringing cloud.
The dance. The dance. The dance. The dance.
The dance.
Sword lying in the field. That was a sign.
Oh, that was a sword in a field.
No, that was a sign.
No, that was a sword in a field.
You can't just get there by itself, huh? You can't. The sword just doesn't get there by itself. It can't just get there by itself.
True. Every event has an infinite number of causes, so why pick one rather than another? There are many ways a sword might find itself in a field. Seems a perfectly valid explanation, but how about this one? But then again, there are other possibilities. Or even faster. And that's without counting the inexplicable. Yet from an infinite number of possibilities, you had to pick this one. You didn't see what was, John. You saw what you wanted to see.
This voice that you say appears to you, is it an angel or a saint, or does it come from God?
I won't tell you any more about that. I'm more afraid of displeasing him than not answering you.
You're afraid of displeasing God by telling the truth?
No.
Did God forbid you to tell the truth?
No, but my revelations were for the King of France, not for you.
When you saw your king for the first time, was there an angel over his head?
If there was one, I did not see it.
Why did your king believe in you without any proof?
Go and ask him yourself.
Dina.
When you were taken prisoner at Compiègne, did you have a horse?
Yes. Half-steed. Black.
Who gave you that horse?
My king.
How many did he give you?
Five steeds and a few hackneys.
As much as for a lord. What an honor. Did your king give you other wealth apart from those horses?
No.
What about all those dresses you were given? Silk dresses, weren't they?
Yes. Yes, I was given a few. But I never had time to wear them.
Still, pretty wealthy for a peasant girl, wouldn't you say?
You look pretty wealthy for a servant of God, wouldn't you say?
You launched an attack on Paris, didn't you?
I tried to.
And didn't you order the citizens of Paris to surrender the city in the name of the King of Heaven?
No. I said surrender in the name of the King of France.
That is not what is written in the evidence. Look yourself.
I can't read.
Ah! Yes, I forgot. God sent us an illiterate peasant to carry out such an important mission. Do you think that God made the right decision? To take an ignorant girl to save the kingdom of France?
I leave that answer to God.
Calm down, my lord, I beg you.
How can I be calm when I made the laughing stock of the whole court?
You've seen how it is. This girl has a way with people, but we're making progress every day.
So long as that bitch remains alive, our armies refuse to fight. Don't you understand? They need proof that God is on their side.
It's not for us to burn her. It's your prerogative.
And it's your prerogative to find her guilty.
But we can't do that unless she admits to blasphemy.
What are you waiting for? You've got a castle full of racks and ropes and pulleys. Let's go torture the bitch.
You'll never get anything out of her that way. And besides, you must realize that several of my colleagues are, well, scared.
Scared? Of a girl?
Scared to make a mistake. Suppose she's right. Suppose she has been sent by God.
Whose side are you on, Koshan?
I'm on the side of Holy Mother Church.
Do you have a sword?
Quite a few.
Didn't you also carry a banner?
Yes.
Which do you prefer, your banner or your sword?
I was 40 times more fond of my banner.
Why was that? Did it have some particular value or power?
No. It's just a sword is a weapon.
And
so, I prefer my banner.
Why?
To avoid killing anyone.
Are you saying if you'd not been carrying your banner, you'd have killed more people?
No, of course not. I never killed anyone.
Then perhaps the temptation to kill would have been stronger. Too strong, perhaps.
No. I warned the English to go back home. I begged them not to force us to fight. They knew the defeat that I would
be. We have numerous witnesses who can confirm you were not always carrying your banner. So sometimes you were carrying just your sword?
Yes! I don't know.
Did you use the sword that you held in your hand?
Yes, I used it to... I held
you
it
You held up your sword and flourished it about in the air like this!
I don't remember.
So, you were in the middle of the battlefield with your sword in your hand, waving it above your head, charging against the enemy, screaming and yelling, fighting for your life! And you expect us to believe that in the middle of all this excitement, you never killed anyone?
No, I never killed anyone.
I can't believe you can lie like that.
I'm not lying. Leave me alone. I can't remember. I never killed anyone. I can't remember.
Let me help your memory.
I don't want to hear anymore. Leave me alone. I didn't kill that man. Leave me alone. Leave me alone. Can't remember. The battles were so confusing. I was only defending myself as best as could. There was so much dust and smoke and noise. I was being attacked on all sides. So maybe, perhaps, I fought back, but it was only to defend myself.
So your memory's coming back.
Yes.
Good.
Yes.
Good.
And now you tell me why God let all those battles happen in the first place.
He's so powerful. You said he's the creator of heaven and earth, the source of all life. He could easily have stopped all that blood and all that misery. Why? Why didn't he?
Is he the one who spread all this blood and misery?
No.
Is he?
But he could have stopped it. Or, what did he get? Pleasure? Pleasure! Pleasure from watching us killing each other in his name.
In his name?
Yes, in his name. We fought and killed in his name, the King of Heaven.
Really?
Let all those who love me follow me!
Let all who love me follow me. Where does God get mentioned? Come on, John. Be honest. You fought for yourself in your name.
No! I was defending myself as best as I could. Everyone has the right to defend themselves, don't they? Yes, they do. Yes, they do. Or should I have let myself get killed? Is that it?
Oh, no, you did fine. I'd even say, well done. As a matter of fact, most of the ones you killed probably deserved it, don't you think?
No. No. I never thought killing each other would bring about any peace.
I agree.
Peace will only be got from the English at the end of a lance.
I don't agree. Why do you keep changing your mind all the time?
Why are you doing this to me? Do you get pleasure from hurting me?
Ah, pleasure. That's a difficult word to define. When does the pain end and the pleasure begin? When did your pleasure begin with that sword in your hand?
I never took pleasure in hurting anyone.
Really?
Jeanne, my very dear friend in Christ, we, your judges and assessors, desirous of reaching a true and lawful verdict, submitted a transcript of your trial to the University of Paris in order to obtain their opinion. After careful consideration, the learned scholars have concluded with us that you have committed many grievous sins. And I ask you now to listen most carefully to their opinion as detailed in these articles.
Article 1.
You said that by God's command you have continually worn men's clothes, and that you have also worn your hair short, with nothing to distinguish you from the soldiers with whom you fought. As to this article, the learned scholars have declared...
Don't abandon me. Please. Where are you? Please. Is this what you want? Is this what you want? You want me to burn without being confessed?
Finally, Article 12. You have said that you are not willing to submit yourself to the judgment of the church militant, but only to God. As to this article, the scholars say that you have no comprehension of the authority of the church, that you have perniciously erred in the faith of God, and that you are a child of superstition, a wanderer from the faith, an invoker of demons, an idolater, and a heretic.
Jeanne, we once again admonish, beg, and exhort you to cast out and recant your erroneous beliefs by signing this recantation. Please.
If the church wants me to say that my visions are evil, then I do not believe in this church.
Perform your office.
Wait.
Jeanne, I beg of you, sign. In God's name, don't you understand? I'm trying to save you.
I want to be confessed.
Sign this, and I will confess you myself if you want.
And may I... May I go to Mass?
As often as you like. Now, for the love of God, sign. Sign, Jan, and you'll be free of your chains. Free of the fire, Jan.
You know what you just signed? You just signed away his existence.
I didn't mean to.
For you, he's a lie. An illusion.
No. He told me that I would be confessed.
In the end, it was you who abandoned him.
May I have that back, please?
You have nothing to regret.
No. Give it back to me! Give it back!
Take it away! Take it away! Silence! There. She has recanted, and we accept her repentance. For the church never closes her arms to those who would return to the fold. Now, she's your martyr, not ours.
Want to get dressed? Try these for size.
My Lord Bishop.
Ah, Cochon. Come to see for yourself.
Well, take a look.
See, dressed as a man again. Her touching repentance didn't last very long, did it? The Bishop of Senlis was passing by and so was on hand to witness her very evident relapse.
And by what miracle did these clothes find their way in here?
Not a miracle, my dear Cochon. An evil spell. This girl is a witch, and tomorrow she will burn for it. Have the stake prepared in the marketplace.
Jan, I don't understand. Why did you do it? Why?
And you? Why did you lie? You promised to have me confessed.
I know. It was the only way to have you saved from the fire.
It's not my body I want to save. It's my soul. I ask only one thing. Please, hear my confession.
I can't, Jan. I can't hear your confession. I'm very sorry.
Please.
confess. I'm listening.
I've committed sins, my lord. So many sins. Ones I wanted to see. I fought out of revenge and despair. I was all the things that people believe they are allowed to be when they're fighting for a cause.
For a cause.
I was proud and stubborn.
Selfish.
Selfish.
Yes. Cruel.
Yes. Cruel.
You think you are ready now?
Yes.
Dub salvo, in nomine Patris, et Filii, et Spiritus Sancti. Amen.